Who do you think's got the harder job? This is sort of a loaded question, and you're going to be biased about this, of course, in your answer. But who's got the harder job, a shuttle commander for a short sprint type of mission, if you will, or a station commander who has to oversee a giant complex for a half year in a multinational environment?
Well, I think I could probably better answer that question, although, you know, I haven't been the station commander, but having had all the training and having a fairly good understanding of what the job entails, they're clearly different. You know, the missions are different. You know, the shuttle is very, you know, the shuttle mission timeline is very scripted. You train practically everything you're going to do multiple times. You have a larger support structure, I think, here at the Johnson Space Center when you're training. As a station crew member, in some ways the training is somewhat more autonomous in that you do a lot of it by yourself. It's in various countries, different systems, and different types of philosophies on design and the hardware. And then, you know, the other thing too is it's more of a, you know, we call it an expedition for a reason. It's it's a long duration mission that involves, you know, being isolated from friends and family. The training also has somewhat of that aspect that you travel around to these different countries. So I think, overall, I think probably the station flight presents more difficulty, but they're kind of really hard to compare because they are so much different.
I think, Rob, I think you almost answered the question in your question. You said the short sprint or the long duration, expedition, and I think just like a race, right? What's harder, the sprint or the, mm-hmm. The long run? And they're hard for their own reasons, and they just have unique, different things about them that are both difficult.
Scott, before we press ahead with a few other types of personal questions about what lies ahead for you all, I'm intrigued always by Soyuz landings. I've been to the landing site many times myself. You've seen the landings on TV. Obviously, you've trained now for them. It's not wheel stop, Houston. It's thump and bang, and they call it the E-ticket. Any U.S. astronaut who has rode home on a Soyuz calls it the E-ticket, basically. What do you think that's going to be like for you?
Well, I think it's an E-ticket if you consider, like, crashing, an E-ticket ride. I mean, my understanding is it's kind of a violent reentry and impact with the Earth that has really gotten some people's attention. I'm glad I've talked to a lot of people about it, so hopefully it won't be as big of a surprise, but it can be, higher G-forces, the Soyuz spins up underneath the parachute, there's a equalization of pressure that, causes the inside of the vehicle, depending on the atmospheric conditions, to fill up with condensation. Can seem rather smoky to people, and then when you hit the ground, it's hard. And then the vehicle, as you've seen, can roll and be in a weird orientation, and all that combined with the fact that your body's somewhat deconditioned and your vestibular system is affected can make it for quite a violent, surprising event.